We've sent Joe to Melbourne on a special mission. He's been updating us on what he's doing. But, Joe, all morning you've been talking it up, getting Tim Cahill himself with you. Where is he?
Look, I'm sorry to disappoint you guys. It's just one of these things that happens with television. We have been here. We showed up at the spot. I've been waiting all morning for Tim, but as you can understand, he's a very busy guy. He's probably the best player in Australia, if not the world right now, and there's just no sign of him. I'm afraid we're going to have... Oh, whoa, hang on, one... Oh, my God!
How are you, my man?
Mate, I'm just so, I feel like as the heavens open, Tim Cahill, ladies and gentlemen, the greatest soccer player of all time. Football, the world game, the beautiful game. Look, as you know, a fellow athlete, can I ask you a really complex football question?
Of course.
Were you sent to Earth by God to deliver Australia into the World Cup?
You know, it's a nice question, but I was sent here to try my hardest to deliver a fourth consecutive World Cup.
But everything you do, like in the last qualifier against Syria, I mean, it's like magic. You kick those the goals right into extra time. It's like a fairy tale. How do you do it?
For me, it's just loads of years of preparation. I think, you know, 20 years being a professional, and I'm obsessed with the game. You know, everything that I do, I try and be a good role model on and off the park. And when you can produce on the big stages, then that's when it counts, and it's awesome.
Mate, thanks to your miraculous efforts against Syria, we're now through to the next stage against Honduras. How do you reckon we're going to go?
I think it's going to be tough, but also we're under no illusions where we've got to go. It's going to be logistically very difficult. You know, we don't know too much about them. It's all about us preparing like we would for any other game. So home game away in Honduras on the 10th and then the 15th back in Sydney. So we're looking for a massive crowd and really looking forward to a bigger game.
And of course, for a while it all looked lost. And then thanks to you and Ange, we're back in the game now. Do you think we can actually go all the way?
I think this is what we're here to do. Like, you know, for me, I'd never be overconfident, but when you're put in this situation of qualifying for a World Cup, and we've done it before, there's no reason why we can't. So we've got a great squad, good staff, and we're excited for something big. And, you know, to make a fourth consecutive World Cup will be big for the grassroots of football in Australia.
And, of course, we are here in my hometown. Melbourne City FC represent. How does it feel to be back in? Because, of course, we were playing over in China for Shanghai for a long time. And I've always thought Melbourne and Shanghai, very similar metropolises, very similar.
Yeah.
How does it feel to be back home and playing full-time in Australia?
No, for me, it's amazing. For me, it's good to be home on Australian shores and just to be travelling to different clubs around the A-League, meeting fans, playing well. As long as I'm playing, I'm happy. You know, that's the main thing.
Because a massive code, it's growing, I think, faster than any other football code in the country. Do you think it's going to overtake AFL and NRL as the number one sport in Australia, number one code?
Well, I see myself as an ambassador of sports. So, you know, I don't really like to compete. I like AFL, I like NRL, I like all them sports, and I think alongside each other we can help, you know, the grassroots level for all codes.
Very diplomatic.
Show us your moves, Joe. Now,
you're also very passionate about fitness, like you. Your body, like me, my body is a temple, like you.
Temple.
Tell us a bit about what you're doing about trying to get Australians fitter.
Well, I think, you know, the great concept with Weet-Bix and lowering cholesterol is something that's pretty awesome. It's amazing, especially with diet. But, you know, I do so much with the Heart Foundations, Heartbeat of Football.
Yep.
And this is definitely something with my relationship that I was really excited about because, you know, everyone suffers with some form of cholesterol. And it's just a great way to help out with that situation.
Fantastic. And of course, one thing we can do is to keep physically fit.
Exactly.
And I don't know if you know this, Tim, but I'm a pretty natural athlete myself.
Ken at his best.
So,
woohoo!
That's right. I thought maybe you and I could sort of just kick the ball around, you know, show me a few
Why
tricks.
Not?
I'm a pretty.
Why not?
Pretty
oh,
quick
look
learner.
At Tim.
Thank you very
Whoa.
Much.
All right. So basically now, right, okay. I'm just going to juggle on our knees. And because I like using my head, we'll just put it in the air like that.
Whoa.
And if you can, just kick it away like that. There you go. And there's someone there.
I think it's still going. All right,
there
that's it. That's pretty
knees.
Easy. No problem. No problem.
Okay. Go, Joe.
One.
Up.
Two. keep it closer.
Natural.
One. There you go. Two.
Oh! Put on his glasses. Oh, no! Oh, he's broken his glasses.
I might just cross back to you guys in the studio and I'll just work on my technique. I think maybe 2018 might be more the year for me. Tim Cahill!
Yeah! Tim Cahill on the show. Now, 1 in 3 Aussies live with high cholesterol, and if you want to make a change, Weet-Bix Cholesterol Lowering is the first breakfast cereal available on supermarket shelves in Australia to be clinically proven to reduce cholesterol in a single serve. If you eat just 2 biscuits a day, you can lower cholesterol levels by up to 9% in 4 weeks. Weet-Bix uses plant sterols and a naturally recurring plant ingredient, clinically proven to reduce cholesterol levels. And because we love our studio audience, you're all going to take some home to try.
Yay!